Back in about 2003, I took a trip up to Yamanshan. We walked up the top of the mountain and it was getting a bit late and we were starting to head down. And one of the friends was maybe 50 meters in front of me, kind of down there by that the lamp over there. She bent down to tie her shoe. She did it right in front of an old man. He was wearing a hat, sitting on a chair, had a big easel in front of him, painting a picture. I thought, really, of all the places you could bend over and tie your shoe, didn't you see that old man painting the picture? And she went, no, what old man? And then I looked around and there was really, absolutely no old man there.
在印尼有很多路边摊，然后在没有人吃的时候，它就会出现。它吃的东西就会从它的后面掉出来，然后老板就会问为什么，然后它就会站起来转身，它的后面就有很大的洞。这就是因为它是一个孕妇，她死的时候她在她的坟墓出生孩子，所以那个孩子从她的后面窜出来。
When I was 15 or maybe 16, I ran away from my house. I just went to my middle school where I graduate, maybe 3 or 4 a.m. I guess. I tried to look inside of main hall of the former middle school. It was the old man with the whole green body. He fading from the right and fade out to the left.
In my country is the legend of La Ciguapa. Mythological creature that resembles a woman, a very beautiful woman. She has beautiful brown skin and long silky hair. She enchants you with her song and then you follow her. The man who follows a Ciguapa either is never found again or is found dead because she kind of kisses the life out of them. It is very hard for you to actually catch her. Her feet are actually backwards. So when she walks, the footsteps that she leaves behind, the footprints, are actually in the opposite direction in which she's going.
Sleeping paralysis is when you are awake and you know you are awake, but you can't. You are on your bed, but you can't move. If you know this phenomenon, you don't need to be afraid. There is no ghost. You just need to relax and control yourself.
你听过最恐怖的鬼故事是什么？留言给我们。 然后别忘记订阅哦。